Trump giving his voters a beautiful Christmas present with an incredible thing he's surprising each one with. Contrary to popular belief among politicians, their job is to serve us and not the other way around. The government has a very specific set of jobs that concern the well-being of the entire country. The military is, of course, a major one, along with roadways and the justice system. There are a few more, but if we want to stay within the original intent of the Founding Fathers, it doesn't go too far outside those boundaries. Those in Washington seem to be pretty sure that they're supposed to be working the country like their own personal sweatshop, milking every dollar they can, and then handing it out in exchange for votes in upcoming elections. Fortunately, President Trump doesn't see it that way. Maybe it's the years spent in the private sector, or maybe it's the massive tax bills that he has had to pay, but the president isn't about to put a bigger tax burden on the American people. In fact, his promise to overhaul the national tax problem, giving relief to Americans and decrease the national debt at the same time seemed impossible, but somehow he's doing it. According to the New York Post, the president's new tax plan will give almost $1,200 back to every single family this year in what is possibly the best Christmas present that most of us have ever gotten. President Trump on Thursday called the tax reform plan unveiled by House Republicans a big, beautiful Christmas present for the American people. "I consider that to be one of the greatest Christmas presents. We are working to give the American people a giant tax cut for Christmas. We are giving them a big, beautiful Christmas present in the form of a tremendous tax cut," Trump said from the Oval Office during an appearance with Broadcom Limited CEO Hock Tan, who with Trump announced that his $100 billion semiconductor company based in Singapore would legally relocate its home address to the U.S. "It will be the biggest cut in the history of our country. It will also be tax reform and it will create jobs. We will make the tax code simpler and fairer. We will restore our competitive edge by reducing business taxes for the first time in more than 30 years," the president said. Broadcom, which manufactures communications chips around the world, said it would relocate its legal address to Delaware once shareholders approved the move, bringing $20 billion in annual revenue back to the U.S. The company credits the GOP plan with making it easier to do business in the U.S. "America is once again the best place to lead a business with a global footprint," Tan said in a statement. "What this effort says about our commander-in-chief is that he understands the problems that middle America faces. We, as hard-working individuals, understand the need for military and police and even the government salaries. However, the glorified redistribution of wealth that has become the welfare system and all of its companions that prop up those who are proud of not working, that is outside the government's scope." So when the president introduces plans to drug test welfare recipients, or not extending benefits to those who enter the country illegally, it makes the hearts of everyone who voted for him sing for joy. That means that while we will still get the benefits of what a government is supposed to do, we will get to keep more of what we rightfully earned. Merry Christmas to us. Here are a few more details about what this tax cut will mean for you and me. Capitol Hill Republicans rolled out the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act Thursday, a tax package that if passed would finally provide President Trump with his first big legislative win. With this plan, the typical family of four will save $1,182 a year on their taxes, House Speaker Paul Ryan, a Republican from Wisconsin, pledged during a rollout press conference on Capitol Hill. Ryan suggested the money could go toward a year's worth of gas for your car or the family phone bill, depending on how much data your kids use, he said with a chuckle. At the White House later, President Trump sold it like this: "We are working to give the American people a giant tax cut for Christmas. We are giving them a big, beautiful Christmas present in the form of a tremendous tax cut," he said. However, at the heart of the GOP's plan is to slash the corporate tax rate from 35% to 20% and pay for that by killing a number of deductions, including that Americans now can subtract what they pay to local municipalities in their states when filing their federal taxes. The bill puts Americans into five tax brackets at 0%, 12%, 25%, and 35% tax rates, with top earners continuing to pay 39.6% of their income. The Tax Cuts and Jobs Act will simplify the code so you can file your taxes on a form the size of a postcard, Ryan said, a pledge Republicans have been making for months as they attempted to roll out a tax package, which had already been delayed this week. That top rate hits single filers who make $500,000 and more, and joint filers who make more than $1 million. Individual filers don't pay taxes on the first $12,000 they make. It used to stand at $6,350. For joint filers, the first $24,000 of income will not be taxed, if the GOP plan becomes law. The popular retirement savings plan, 401ks, ended up not being touched, though as of Wednesday, House Ways and Means Chairman Kevin Brady, a Republican from Texas, had wanted them on the table. Tax deductions would be capped at $500,000 on new mortgages. The current tax code's cap is $1 million. This could impact Americans living in large, high-cost cities including San Francisco, New York, Boston, and Washington, D.C., cities that didn't vote for President Trump in last year's presidential election. However, the bill would allow people to deduct the first $10,000 of local property tax from their federal tax bill.